Welcome back.
Yeah, the more I see of your boss, the more I like him.
I was you, I wouldn't be so critical of who others associate with.
So is he gonna be a problem?
For sure. But there's nothing we can do about it. If something happened to him right now, I'd be right under a microscope. An electron microscope of bureaucratic shit. And that would make it very difficult to keep old secrets.
Oh, well, boo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo for you. You know who else is having trouble keeping secrets, asshole? Me. After you brought Trevor in on this.
I only brought him in after you put out your press release. Townley's taking scores again. The Los Santos reboot. If we didn't control the situation and he'd unearthed this connection, then what?
Then Trevor flips out, beheads me, kills my family, or raises them as his own. I don't know which is worse. Anyway, any of that could happen at any time.
Slow down. Let's think this through. What does he know?
He knows I'm alive. He knows I got money. And now he knows I'm working with the FIB.
Does he know how long you've been working with the FIB?
How long? The fuck does that matter?
Either you were working with us before the Cash Depot job, you walked your crew into an ambush, one of them spent 10 years on the run, and the other landed in a federal penitentiary. Or we stumbled on the Cash Depot job, Brad went down, you went down, Trevor got away. The FIB cut you a deal on your sickbed, faked your death, and you end up here.
Who's to say which of those is true?
That there's any doubt probably accounts for you being alive.
Back there, Trevor made you right away. The second he saw you.
You remember after the bust, I was in all the papers. I was on the evening news. The man who killed Michael Townley.
Yeah, I was quite a trophy. A good head to hang on your wall.
Back then, sure. Not now.
Well, welcome back to GTA 5.
This is bullshit. This place, Davey, they've been shooting the real cunts of suburbia here the last few weeks. No way that's your guy.
Shit. You are kidding me. I'll call Steve. Wrong house. This guy isn't our guy.
Okay. You sure you don't want to silence him just to make sure?
We're silencing someone. We're silencing the right someone. Get me another address. Hey, you want a coffee?
Can I get you anything?
Turns out that was the wrong Azerbaijani. We need a new address from Mr. K. Choose your instrument and go to work on it.
Ooh. Where do we start, eh, buddy?
Wait! What are you talking about, the wrong guy? No! Who do you want? Just tell me what you want, huh, man? Huh, please, look at me, please.
This is an important part of the great democratic experiment.
Let's get a tooth. Tooth or fingernail?
Not the flyers.
Oh, tooth.
I just had them laced.
Best way to make a man talk is to stop him being able to talk.
That hurts too much!
Mr. Phillips, ask him about Tahir Javan.
What did you ask me? I know Tahir. I did his home theater. He lives in Chumash. The right on the Western Highway.
Well, that wasn't so tough, was it?
Huh? Did you get that? Did you hear him? Lives in Chumash, the Western Highway.
Chumash, you're driving. Remember, terror does not take coffee breaks.
What a dick.
All right. Let's go.
So how are Steve and Trevor getting along?
Seems like a productive relationship.
You know, like I said, he's got his uses.
And as you can see, we're trying to take full advantage of it.
Then what?
This thing with the agency gets put to rest and we don't need you anymore.
Right. And what about Trevor?
What about him?
I need some resolution, Davey.
Watch it!
You let
let him walk. You said you'd clean the whole thing up back in North Yankton.
And you told me it'd be a clean job, no casualties. There were more eyes on that town than there needed to be.
Yeah, well, according to my eyes, Trevor's your problem, Dave, as much as he is mine.
He's not a problem at all. We're monitoring him. Has he said anything about Brad?
Fuck yeah, he has. Plenty. I keep changing the subject. You know, he thinks you might actually commute Brad's sentence when this is all over.
That's good. Fine work. We'll send another letter. It's about time anyway.
Oh, so that's you who's been sending those fucking letters to Trevor, huh?
Yeah. He thinks they're from Brad, who he thinks is locked up in high security and not, well, not 6 feet under in a grave marked Michael Townley. The trainees write them. It's a good exercise.
Yeah, the fuck. How'd that get started?
This'll do.
Alright. Find out who we're looking for.
Yeah, we need a description of the target.
Yeah, I'll take care of it. Loosen him up.
No, no, please. I tell
what?
You what
loosen
you want
him
to
up.
Know. No, please.
I'm gonna level with you. This'll hurt.
Not the clips! Not the clips! No clips! I will die! No!
Ooh.
Hey. Electrifying.
Huh? Now you ready to talk?
I've been ready to talk. I got kidnapped. The second
That's
fix
what
ago.
We were afraid of. So,
yeah. This
talk.
Guy we're after. What does he look like?
I was built. I was like middle age.
Yeah. It sounds like you're stalling. This better
dark
be enough. Middle age, middle height, middle build, whatever. He's dark. Okay. He's Azerbaijani, for God's sakes. Look around. That enough for you?
We're live.
You see anyone down there who might be an Azerbaijani?
Fuck do I know? You might be an Azerbaijani for all I know. What's one look like?
They look Eastern.
Half this town looks Eastern, Davey. You got the fall of the Shah and the collapse of communism to thank for that.
Anyone stand out?
No, they all kind of blend in. Make a call, Dave.
We're gonna need some more info on this guy. They're having a party down there.
That ain't gonna cut it, my friend.
Shit. Let me think. I remember.
Sorry, too late. Trevor, show our contestant what he's won today.
I remember. Oh, okay. I remember.
This is a mental battle, my brother. You gotta convince yourself you're not gonna drown.
I will drown. I will. Say this. I will drown. My mouth! I was drunk!
I don't see what all the fuss is about personally.
He's had enough.
Yep, he comes.
I'm alive. I'm alive.
The government knows what's best for you.
Then the government should kill me.
So what have you got for us? We need Trev to shake up your memory again?
No, please. He's got beard.
Oh, he's got beard?
He's got Gucci beard.
Uh-huh. No. I think you're making this up.
No, I'm not.
Huh?
No.
Yeah?
I'm telling you the truth.
Gucci beard? Got any beardy types at this party? Huh? Because that's all Mr. K's given us.
No.
You know, I'm thinking maybe we ought to just take two bullets and put them in our informant and just call an airstrike on Chumash Beach.
We're back in. Give me some eyes.
Who am I looking for?
Steve saying beard. What do you got?
Anything specific or is some stubble gonna cut it?
Let's start at Mountain Men and we'll work our way down until someone fits the profile.
Ah, there's a few beards at this party. Vinewood's full of weak chins. Place is famous for it.
Damn. Beards are in fashion in Chumash. Land of beach hipsters. We need more.
Okay.
Long day until you give us some intel on our target.
He's got beard. He smokes like a fucking chimney.
I don't know. Trev, maybe one more time? Just to be sure.
No, please, no. Huh? I told you, he smokes. That's all I know.
Where you want it?
Nowhere.
I hope you're not a skier. Hasn't this man done enough for national security? Here goes.
How long was I out?
Mr. K. Mr. K.
I don't know anything, please.
Okay.
He chain smokes. And he's left-handed.
What's that?
He chain smokes. And he's left-handed.
Ah, okay.
Any of these bearded guys at the party smoke cigarettes? Mr. K says he smokes like a pack of two a day.
Redwood cigarettes?
Thank you, Mr. K.
Steve's telling me he chain smokes Redwoods.
It ain't the cigarettes that'll kill him. It's the guys who put the warnings on the packets you should worry about.
And he's left-handed.
Oh, now I get it. You're telling me to assassinate a guy because he's got facial hair, a cigarette, and he's left-handed.
What the hell?
That was the guy. I had a feeling. It'll check out.
Well, we've got him. It's done.
Woo! That is a wrap, my friends. Excellent work, the pair of you. Now I got a rapid ball game to get to, so Trevor, if you take
it's
care
that
of
guy.
Guy,
I'm saying it's gonna be him.
To do with him. I would say he's outlived his usefulness.
Oh, come on, please.
Shut up! That's a sport. Let's go. Come on.
Wait a second, Mitsu.
Fuck, let's just go, okay? I ain't gonna let those G-Man fucking scumbags tell me what to do.
What? You just tortured me.
Don't ask too many fucking questions. Let's go. Get up. Come on, up the fucking stairs. Oh, fuck's sakes. Come on. Let's go. All right. Now you got a flight to catch. Okay? Let's get you to the airport. Oh, safety first.
Okay.
Hey, how's your mouth?
It hurts.
Can you speak?
Kinda.
Are you gonna hold it together?
I don't want to go home. I want to see my family.
No. You have no home. You have no family. That shit is over.
I do. They're in the morning wood. I love them very much.
No, that's your old life. That's over now. You're off the grid. You're one of the invisible people.
Just take me home!
I'm taking you to the airport. You're gonna get on a plane. You're flying a long way from this country, and you're gonna spread your message.
I don't have a message!
You're a torture advocate!
Advocate?
The media and the government would have us believe that torture is some necessary thing. We need it to get information, to assert ourselves. Did we get any information out of you?
I would have told you everything.
Exactly. Torture's for the torturer, or the guy giving the order to the torturer. You torture for the good times. We should all admit that. It's useless as a means of getting information.
I'm feeling lightheaded.
Sometimes you torture for the torturee, but only if they're prepared to pay. Departures. No one drives me to the airport. It would be... Run. You're free.
Oh, what? But my family's here.
Your family is probably the ones who got you fucking in here, all right?
Now look, trust no one, all right? You're alone now.
Really?
Yeah, really. Now let's go. Fuck off. Come on.
All right. Ooh, rampage. That guy over there. Let's go do the T one. So, we're going to end here. So, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, let me know down in the comments below. Otherwise, subscribe and support the notification bell to keep up to date. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.